Hello guys. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, I am wearing the same freaking clothes I always wear because it's quarantine season, so I'm not really leaving my house, so I don't have to change that often. I am gonna try making myself look good today because it's been a really long time. Honestly, like since the quarantine started, I kind of forgot like how I looked, you know, because I'm always used to looking. Just fucking broke my nail. I'm so used to looking at myself looking terrible. So like, I thought maybe today I can like spice things up and like look hot, you know? I've also been trying to do the whoa, but not really good at it yet. But I'm gonna try to make myself look good. I'm gonna try to be a catfish. This is kind of like my starting canvas that I'm starting with. If you guys don't think I'm ugly, like you're wrong. Like I've always been a really ugly child. Like growing up, I was so ugly. I can't even show you the photos because I found like a really old photo like during my peak ugly season. And my brother who grew up with me, okay, my entire life, I like showed him this photo. He's like, oh my God, I completely forgot you used to look like this. I was like, yeah, yeah. I wish I could say me too, but I can't. So yeah, this is kind of what we're starting with. My hair is darker, so I think it looks a bit better than it used to look before. And my eyebrows look like shit, but it's okay, we can fix that because there are like so many holes in them. My skin also looks like shit, but it's okay, they have foundation. My teeth look like shit too, but there's not very much we can do about that. First step to making yourself look like a catfish or look good in catfish guys. Not that I know anything about catfishing guys because I'm literally the singlest person you'll ever meet. The first thing is I'm gonna remove these ratchet glasses and I'm gonna go put in some contacts. And I'm also gonna put some sunscreen on my face because a part of looking like a catfish is looking like a catfish in the long term. So when you get older and when you're like 50, you know, you don't wanna be shriveled up like a raisin. You kinda wanna be like Shakira or J-Lo, you know? You want the youthful glow. The sun is like really bad for your skin and you really don't wanna let a single photon of light touch the skin. And also I use mineral sunscreen, so my face is gonna be white, just warning you. So I'm back. I put in my contacts and I put sunscreen on my face. So that's why my face looks really white. It looks really bad. Yeah, I wear mineral sunscreen because some dermatologist on YouTube said that mineral sunscreen is like less irritating to your skin, so. The next thing I'm gonna do is put my hair up so that when I start my transformation, my hair doesn't get in my face. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put some foundation on my skin. So let's start off with, I'm gonna use a beauty blender and I'm gonna put some foundation. So I asked my housemate Liz what I should talk about while I do my makeup. She said, I'm gonna use my ordinary foundation. It's all right, it's good. She said that I should talk about being a girl in engineering. And what better person to talk about being a girl in engineering than a girl who just graduated? Well, I'm not technically graduated because I still have like a month of school left. But because of quarantine, I'm technically done. So all the experiences that I've had thus far, I've had 5 years of undergrad in engineering, and I was just gonna talk to you about that and how it was and like how it went and like what it's like being a girl in engineering. And you know, if you guys are thinking about engineering, I know when I was in high school, like when they make you select what classes you wanna take and like what you wanna do like after you graduate grade 12. So like it was really hard and like I was doing a lot of research and like, I don't know, I was under the impression that there weren't any girls in engineering, which I didn't really, I know some girls like think that's like hot, they're like, oh my God, I'm gonna get a guy. But like, I kind of didn't because I wanted to have like friends who are girls. And I definitely do have friends who are girls who are in engineering. So it's not like, it's not impossible, but it is like more rare to find a girl in engineering. Yeah, like if you think that you're gonna go into engineering and find like this plethora of like, good men, like that's just, girl, you're dreaming, like that's not gonna happen. Like the guys in engineering are like, I don't know, they're just not it. Okay, am I the only one who does this? I have like the setting spray, but I actually filled it up with water because it was like gone. And then I like spray this water setting spray thing all over my face. And then I like go again with the beauty blender. And I feel like it makes it look so good. In first year it was okay. Like it wasn't that noticeable because a lot of the, like the way my school was is that it had like a general first year where like it was just like a general engineering program and you didn't have to like specialize yet. For example, like in second year we chose like the stream of engineering we want to go into, for example like chemical or like mechanical or like electrical, stuff like that. But first year, it was like all the engineering students just took the same classes. So honestly, it felt like a pretty good split. Like, but then when I went into EngFizz, like there definitely were way less girls in engineering. And like my engineering discipline, which I graduated from, is engineering physics, which I think has very few girls. And a lot of them are kind of like geeky guys. That's just the demographic. And honestly, like I just didn't like, like I never really fit in with them, you know? Like they're like, I don't know anything about like games. Like I don't know anything about video games. Like I seriously don't. Like I just don't see why, like, to be in engineering you have to like know something about like Dungeons and Dragons, because I don't. I literally like, I also don't care. Like I'm not gonna sit at home and play a video game. Like I'm in my room clearly filming YouTube videos for my YouTube channel with like makeup. Like this is not what they think is like cool. And like sitting at home and like playing, like watching anime and like playing video games, like I just don't do that. Although there are some animes that I've watched. For example, okay, I know Avatar The Last Airbender isn't an anime, and I think that they were trying to go with like the anime style for it, but like I know it's not an anime because it was made in LA and like not in Japan, so it doesn't really qualify as an anime. But I've watched Death Note, and Death Note is so good. Oh my god. Especially, like, it started getting bad after when the first L was, like, defeated, and then they got a new L. That was, like, so stupid. Like, you can't just get a new L. Like, anyway, I think that it should have ended there. I have so many breakups, guys. Like, I don't know. Like, I've always had acne, like, since high school. I think in middle school I started getting acne, but it wasn't really bad in middle school yet. It started getting bad in, like, high school. And then I started using benzoyl peroxide, which helped my skin so much, but like my skin was so irritated from the benzoyl peroxide. Like it was always red, it was always like mad at me. Like I just don't think my skin really liked the benzoyl peroxide. Like every time I'd put it on, like it like wasn't, like if I skipped a day of benzoyl peroxide and then I did it the next day, my skin would get like re-irritated, right? Because like if I use benzoyl peroxide for a long time, like my skin would kind of like develop like a tolerance to it. But if I skipped one day, it was like, that's it. Like it was mad. It was like, did you just fucking skip a day? Like, you like don't know what's coming for you, girl. Okay. I got these new like brushes because they were on sale. They were like super fucking cheap. From Q. I don't know how you say that, but I'm gonna try using them. Honestly, my skin's still dry. Ugh. See, I have some dry skin here. Okay, so basically after benzoyl peroxide, I kind of got into like the whole skincare world, and I started using retinol, and I used the Inkeylist, which is a brand. It's called the Inkeylist. The Inkeylist. No one ever knows what I'm talking about when I say it, but it's the Inkeylist retinol, and it was so good. I really loved it. I've never tried the Ordinary retinol because I live in Canada, and like the Grand Active Ordinary retinol, which I always wanted to try, isn't sold in Canada. It's so annoying. Now I'm just gonna like use this to like kind of go over these areas in my face, kind of highlight. And then I spray this water. I just love when I mix my foundation with water. Like, I don't know, it's kind of an obsession. But then I decided I was gonna go ask my dermatologist if she can prescribe some higher, like real strength retinol. And I have retinol, and I've been using it for like a few months now. And honestly, like, I feel like my skin has gotten so bad. And like, my dermatologist even told me, she's like, just so you know, like, this is gonna make your skin like bad for a while before it gets good. And I was like, okay, yeah, yeah, bring it on. But I don't know, I'm starting to think that it's never gonna get good, because it's been, I started using it at the end of January, and right now it's like the end of March. Like, how long is this like purging period? Oh my god. Okay, next step is the eyebrows. So I'm gonna get my eyebrow jar. I have like little jars for like the different like parts of my face. So this is my like skin jar, or like my foundation. Like it's a whole bunch of foundations. And now I have to get my eyebrow jar. This is the eyebrow pencil I use. Take in that this video was supposed to be me talking about engineering and being a girl in engineering, but it turned into me talking about my skin. But you know what? That's life, guys. That's life. You never know what you're gonna get. Okay, so for my eyebrows, I'm just gonna fill them in. Okay, so first I brush them down like this. You see how ugly that is? Like brush them down. And then I'm gonna fill in like the top so that I have like a better arch, because I need it. And now I'm gonna brush my entire eyebrow up. Keep in mind, I have no idea what you guys can see because I can't see the back of my phone. So this whole video could just not be in frame. I love that for me. So basically being a girl in engineering, like, I don't know, it's honestly not that bad. Like, I have some great friends, like my housemates are all in engineering and they're amazing. And some of the guys in engineering, like, they just, like, I don't even know what to talk to them about. Like, it's hard. I had a co-op where I worked in like an actual engineering firm. And let me tell you, if you thought undergrad was not diverse, oh boy. Like, basically I worked in like a real engineering place and there was not very many women. The women that were there, like, I remember one day I made a friend who was like a girl. She was like a woman. She was like an older, she wasn't older. She was like maybe in her late 20s. I was like, oh my God, another girl. And she was like in the electrical engineering department. I was like, hey, like, how are you? And like the first conversation I had from her was like, yeah, so I'm starting a business. So hopefully I can quit my job soon. I'm selling like these vegan milkshakes. I'm like, oh my gosh, girl. Like, I'm a vegan and I agree with this, but also get out of here. Like, okay, so the biggest problem with being a girl in engineering, in my opinion, is that people just like don't really think that you're smart. They think that you're an idiot all the time. Like, any feminine energy that you have, like, just to them means that you're stupid. Like, if you like speak like the way I speak, like an idiot, then you just are an idiot. Like, that's just the way it is. And like, you, there's no way that you could know what you're talking about. Like, if you wake up in the morning and you do your makeup, like, that just means you're an idiot. Like, what you should be doing is waking up in the morning and doing your homework, I guess. So basically in second year, I really truly believe this to my core, and so many people I felt like around me also like perpetuated this myth that to get stuff done, you have to like wake up super early and go to bed super late and always be grinding. And there was like no time for anything fun that you wanted to do. Like, if you like took a day off, like, just kill yourself. Like, you're not achieving anything. You are a bum in life. Like, just, why are you even here? And I believe this in second year and third year. And then I think it was like around fourth year where I realized that this is ridiculous. Like, that's so stupid. That's not true. Like, you can sleep 8 hours every night and have friends and have hobbies. And if anything, it just makes you more productive because the time that you spend working on actual like schoolwork or actual productive work, you're actually working really like productively. And I feel like I didn't really understand that, but now I do. Like, I just don't believe in like grinding all day. Like, it's impossible. Like, if you are waking up every day and you think you're gonna grind every day and you can't do anything fun or have any side hustles or have any hobbies, like, that's just not a productive life. Like, I'm sorry, but it's not. And it took me a while to realize that. So I have one palette and one palette only, my Soft Glam palette. So I'm gonna use that.
I think I'm gonna do Rustic right here.
Just this nice chocolatey brown. I really love chocolate browns. You know what? These brushes aren't that bad. Like, look at how many brushes came in the set. So it was like, I think it was like $25 because it was on sale. And there was like so many brushes. Like, I honestly have so many and they're all different sizes. I'm obsessed with this and they're not even that bad, honestly. My friend told me not to get them. She's like, oh my God, I've tried this before, it's not good. But I think it's lit, I think it's good. Look at how many. Am I missing any? Yeah, I'm missing one here. Like, look at that collection. So many brushes. What is this, like 10 brushes for $25? Oh my gosh, yes please. I am a frugal baddie. If anyone knows me, like, they know I'm frugal. Like, ask anyone and they'll tell you I'm frugal Fran. Like, I am the most frugal person in the world. I chew a gum. Like, if somebody gives me a gum, I can't have a full piece of gum. Like, I can only have half a piece of gum. I bite the gum and I save the other half for later because I can't waste a full gum. Like, that's just ridiculous. Like, what kind of society and tax bracket are you guys living in that you can afford a full piece of gum? Like, I am clearly not in that tax bracket because I am so poor. Okay, I think I'm gonna finish doing my eyelid and then I'll come back to you guys. I feel like one eyebrow looks taller than the other. I'm gonna curl my eyelashes and I'm gonna put on some mascara. So this is gonna take a lot of focus, so I can't really talk. My eyes are done. And now it's my favorite part of all of makeup, which is the contour and the highlight. I love this part. For the contour, I only have like one contour. Oh my God, Fenty Beauty though. Or like, not Fenty Beauty, like Fenty Savage, like the Rihanna collection where she does like the new fashion show that Rihanna has. Oh my god, it totally destroyed Victoria's Secret. And you know what? I'm kind of glad it did, because I really do think that Victoria's Secret was setting unrealistic body expectations for women. Because look, they're really skinny, okay? And like, maybe some people are naturally skinny, but all of those girls were really skinny. And if I were ever to be that skinny, it would be because I was ill, okay? I can't get that skinny. And I only have one shade of blush. Also, do you guys like Paris Hilton? Because I love Paris Hilton. I follow this Instagram account where they post like, I think it's called like Paris 2000s or something. They post like old videos of Paris Hilton when she was friends with, what's her name? Nicole Richie. Oh my god, they're so funny. They're insane. It's so funny. The thing is that because of my skin disease, my dermatologist said I wasn't supposed to use anything fragranced. And I just keep accidentally buying fragrance stuff because I just, it's so hard. And like, they don't really put like the ingredients of like makeup products, right? So like, how am I supposed to know if it's fragranced or not? Because my dermatologist said not to use fragrance. Like, what am I supposed to do? I promise you, I used to have like an olive glow, like an olive complexion before this, but because of the quarantine, I can't really leave my house. So last step is to do the lips. I actually don't know why I'm taking my hair down yet, because this is not the correct procedure that I'm supposed to do it. Okay, I'm gonna use this lip pencil. Oh my god, it really needs to be sharpened. Whatever, I'll sharpen it next time. What I do for my lips is I just mix every color I have in this little lip jar together all over my lips. Eventually, it just starts to look decent. And if it doesn't, then I take this, I pat some of it off, and then I continue. And eventually, I just get a shade that I'm happy with. The reason why I do this is because I can't seem to find any shade of lipstick that I like, so. Alright guys, I forgot to actually put setting spray on my face. So I got my setting spray. This is what it is. It's a morning dew. I love a dewy face, guys. I love it. Maybe I put too much. Maybe it's Maybelline. Now I'm gonna brush my hair and I'm gonna curl it a little bit. Now I don't like to curl my entire hair. I don't like to curl my entire hair because it like damages my hair. And I'm not about damaging my hair. So I'm just gonna like brush it out. And every night when I go to sleep, I like put my hair up in a braid so that I have a little bit of like volume curl to it. And then I just take my curling iron out and I just do like the front sections of my hair. I'm just gonna take like the front sections like this and just curl them away from my face. What hair color do you guys like on me? I've honestly really been feeling the dark, like my housemates convinced me to dye my hair darker, but I honestly love it. It's so nice. Oh my gosh, I feel like it really brings out my eyes, you know? I used to have like more medium brown hair, but I'm digging this dark look, really. So I think I said I dyed my hair with henna, and I've dyed my hair with henna before and it was red, right? So I was really like scared that like, I don't know, I'd be stuck with red hair forever. But the color I'm really happy with actually, it looks really good. I'm obsessed. So here is the completed hair look. I hope that I'm all in frame so you guys can see it. Now for some finishing touches, I think I'm gonna add some jewelry. So I'm gonna do, because I love to be a boss, and nothing says boss more than hoop earrings. I am obsessed with hoop earrings. I wear hoop earrings every day. I wear them to lecture. These hoop earrings, I think they're like from Forever 21 before it shut down. I love just like cheap jewelry. Mostly because I can't afford real expensive jewelry. I think I'm gonna add some like, I buy all my lip glosses from Bath & Body Works. See this, I really like this color. This is by Bath & Body Works. And then this one, it tastes like cookies. It's so good. Like it's all like, where do I get it anymore? Did Bath & Body Works close forever? Like, is it like Forever 21? Like, why are all my childhood stores closing? Oh my gosh. Okay, so this is the completed look now, for real, for real. Think? Do you think I can snatch a guy like this? Like, what do you think? Not that we're hunting for guys or girls, because we are strong, independent women who don't need nobody, but we like to look hot for our damn selves. I hate when people are like, oh my god, where are you going? I'm literally in quarantine, I'm sitting in my house, like no one's gonna see this. I'm doing this for me, you know? Because you have to constantly remind yourself that you are gorgeous, okay? You are funny, you are smart, you are gorgeous. You're a queen, you know? You really have to believe this. You really, say it with me. You are a queen. I can't hear you.
That's right.
And don't you forget it. I hope you enjoyed my transformation from an ugly girl who never leaves your house to a pretty girl who never leaves your house. Thanks for watching. Bye.